think of the syllable. Do you know the word syllable? Pronunciation u.
Y piensa de la pronunciación u.
Yeah. Okay, so that you do. So when your tone is beautiful, it's the best. But you have to make every note beautiful.
Entonces tu tono, cuando tu tono está lindo, está bellísimo, es el mejor. Pero para eso debes hacer que cada nota sea lindísima.
Okay. So then you get, yeah, it's okay. Squeak? No, you have to blow. You have to keep the wind going and don't adjust here, right? So that you must trust your wind all the way through. Okay, now when you get here, have you performed this with piano before?
No.
Okay. When you get here, the piano goes so you have to make sure that you don't rush, you don't go too fast. Right?
Okay.
So this time, when you, yeah, because you go, too fast, right? You have to think boom ba ba boom boom ba ba boom boom ba ba boom boom ba ba. Okay, so you start here. I will sing the piano part. Okay. Go ahead, it's okay. You know, when I came from where I live, yeah, where I live, the elevation is zero.
Wow.
Yeah.
2,800.
Yeah, exactly. So it takes a lot of wind, and my reeds, they play very differently than they do. Okay, now here you have to show where the peak of the phrase. Okay, so you have to show. Right? Because if you play all the same, everyone gets bored. You know what bored? Yeah. Even if it's easy, you must always be musical. Right? There is a state next, United States has 50 states, right? Yeah. Iowa is in the middle.
Iowa is in the middle of Estados Unidos.
But there is a state next door to Iowa called Nebraska.
Pero hay un estado al lado de Iowa en Estados Unidos llamado Nebraska.
And then when you drive through Nebraska, very flat.
Y cuando pasas por Nebraska, todo es super plano.
Right. But then I get so tired, I get so sleepy because there's nothing to do, right?
Right?
So you don't want to play music like this either. You must have something, okay? So you show everybody where you want to get louder, softer, okay? Not too much, but show something. All the way from here to here. Yeah. See, they're more impressed by the fact that every note can be heard.
Están más impresionados porque cada nota puede ser oída.
You didn't play it that much slower.
No lo hiciste tanto así más bajo.
But it was just enough. But it sounds so much more impressive. You understand?
Yes.
Yeah. Then what you do is you go back to this, and then you try to think of where the musical places are. Remember here?
Yes.
Then you have to do everything here, what you did here, so that you have the high points. But the fingers are so much better now. Yeah, and it feels good. Yeah, doesn't it feel good to be in control?
No se siente mejor estar en control.
Yeah, right?
And how I practice this part?
I use a metronome every day.
Yes.
Right?
Usa un metronomo todos los días.
And then I write here, okay, you know, whatever, 92, 96, 100, 104. So that I know, when we perform, we cannot use the metronome, of course.
No puedes usar los metrónomos cuando estás en front de una orquesta.
But because you repeat with the metronome when you practice so much, your fingers start to learn what the tempo should be.
And when I practice with piano, also?
Yeah, your piano, your pianist needs to listen to you. Right? Because, you're the one that should be setting the tempo. Because if your piano play too fast, if my pianist plays too fast, I stop. Right? Because, we have to work together. Yeah. So that they don't, otherwise they then you look like a fool otherwise. Yeah, that was so much better. You want to play a little more?
Yes.
Maybe one section. Here and then I don't know where to stop after that. Yeah. Well, let's see. Okay, but when you get to the fast part, think of, don't think fast, think clear.
Thank you.
just to make it sound easy, but you're doing very, very nicely. Very nicely. Okay? This thing, one thing that'll help, is to, this is called, this the word we use in as a clarinet is to clip. Clip the notes. Yeah, no, just the last note.
Okay.
No. No.
Okay.
So you lift on those notes. That way, because here you're playing both the accompaniment and the melody at the same time. Correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Sometimes I practice without making sound so that I can. See? Mm-hmm. You do that. And then, but I want you to watch so that they stay low. With sound, but don't change.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
started when you're nine years old or so?
Ten
years old? Yeah, you like it?
Yes.
Yeah, good. Yeah, you play very nicely. You have a nice tone quality.
Tienes una super, tocas super bien y tienes una super buena calidad de tono.
Yeah. So you use your he uses his wind very good.
Tú usas tu aire super bien.
Okay. Now we're going to try to make his tone a little better.
Vamos a intentar hacer el tono un poquito mejor.
Right. So the first thing I want you to do is try to make your bottom lip.
Lo que primero quiero que hagas es intentar hacer que tu labio de abajo.
Yeah. I want to see if you can make sure that you roll the bottom lip over the teeth.
Quiero intentar hacer que intentas hacer que el labio de abajo ande atrás de los dientes de aquí.
This way? Yeah. Sometimes I see in him a little bit this way. Try. Yeah. Go ahead. Okay. Just a little more. Little bit. Like the sound?
Yes.
Yeah. So you just have to make sure just a little more of your lip.
We call
it. How do you say lip?
Labio.
Labio?
Labio.
Yeah. Okay. Not too much.
No.
Just try. Okay? Try beginning. Take a breath.
Cada vez que tomas
then your lip goes back to original. So every time you take a breath, we try one more time. But every time you take a breath, I want you to take more time to breathe, and then make sure that his lip goes back to the new way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Entonces, cada vez que tomas un respiro, haz un poquito más grande el respiro y acuérdate de mantener hacia adentro el labio. Does it feel different too? Se siente diferente también?
Sí, se siente
diferente. Yeah. So you have to get used familiar with a new feeling.
Debes ponerte familiar con ese nuevo sentimiento.
Okay, but try to do that, and then the more you think about it, then pretty soon it becomes very easy.
Lo más que lo piensas sobre eso, lo más rápido que se hará es familiar.
Yeah, okay, so just make sure you're right. Okay, good, good. Now, can you do that? I'm not sure what to get it back.
This is looking really hard.
Okay.
Then, and
okay. Good. Now, let's talk about tummy articulation.
Yeah.
One of the hard things to do with the clarinet is to tongue. Ta 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 ta.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what I want to help you with just a little bit is to be able to tongue lighter.
Quiere que hagas, digamos, a usar la lengua un poquito, digamos, más suavemente.
So we're going to start here. Same thing with our tongue, right? Yeah, but if we're too heavy, then we cannot play fast. Too heavy. Light. One more time. start here one more time. Da, da, but play the way he learned. Playing this piece? Six months? Have you performed?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yesterday.
Oh, yesterday! With piano?
Yes.
Oh, good.
No, but no, I don't know who.
Is he nervous?
No,
yeah.
Okay.
This is a
let's start here. Okay. I want him to play. I don't want him to be nervous. So just relax. Go. Bigger breaths. Okay? Sometimes when I see you breathe, you do this. Did you see me breathe? Yeah. So when I breathe, right? To be able to go a long time on way he plays?
Okay.
Yeah, you have to stop that. Right? Yeah. Yeah. Santiago, and how old are you, Santiago?
22.
22?
Mm-hmm.
How long you been playing?
I think that 14.
14 years, excellent. And you in college, university, or?
College.
College,
yeah.
And you want to be professional, or?
Yes.
Or do you have something else? Are you?
Yes, I'm studying business.
Business, yeah,
no,
that's good.
I'm studying music in university.
Same thing, yes. Music and business, same thing. Yeah, music and business, same time. Yeah, very good. That way, you know how to make money. Maybe. Okay. Tell everybody what you are playing.
Bueno, voy a tocar. Una obra que se llama Bucolí, es de Eugene
Bozza.
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 Bozza. do that. Just do that. Yeah, just do that. Just do this one more time. Yeah.
Can you give me 1 second?
Yeah, yeah. Trying to say something. It's very dramatic.
Es super dramático.
Yeah, so that's what you want to do with this piece. Yeah. And not only do you play all the notes, but you make it very interesting for your listener. Yeah. I only have two comments, two very simple comments. Number one, when you go back to practice this, not necessarily now, but when you go back to practice it, maybe you don't need to breathe as many times as you do. I don't know if you plan your breathing.
Cuando tú andes, cuando sigues practicando, intenta respirar menos veces, y planeas tú, digamos, cuando vas a respirar o no.
Yes. In some places, it's the breath mark.
Yeah, but you know, even if there is printed breath marks, I think that's only recommendation,
okay.
Not necessarily required. You know, so if you feel good to leave it out,
okay.
It's okay.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. You don't have to follow all the rules perfectly. Because there are some, you understand me,
yeah?
And then maybe you can, but there are some places where you breathe where I don't think you need to. Yeah. So I want you to play, because we are all, we all play a wind instrument.
Yeah.
And then so every time we take a breath, of course, there's a big silence. So anytime you can remove a silence and continue to play, better.
Yeah.
Because you're doing a little circular breathing too, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sometimes.
Sometimes.
Yeah, but you know, if you don't need to breathe, then just keep going, right? Just like a violinist. Would just,
I'm going to cross out. Yes.
Yeah, I don't think, unless your teacher says, no, just breathe. But I don't think so, okay? And then, so I want you to play beginning to here, and take, don't breathe so often, okay? So more continuous. My second comment. he's trying, you are trying so hard to play soft high. But don't try to play so soft that it doesn't speak. Right? It's more important that the note come out.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of trying to play the softest note ever produced. Right?
Yeah.
So when we perform, we are always, as performers, if we are musicians, actors, or dancers, we are always making decisions every second. Yeah. And then so, you know, if we're in a small room, if you have a reed that is not responding as well as you like, there's all kinds of reasons that you have to change just a little bit. Mm-hmm. Play just a little louder than you thought.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have to make very good, those are all things that you do as a performer. You agree? Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I want you to start here. And yes, I want you to get soft, but they must speak. Okay? How about here? Okay? Places where you can eliminate a breath, think about that. So soft. This is a trick, right? Because if you start too soft, then there's no way that will come out, right? So you have to start a little louder, okay? But when you crescendo, decrescendo, do not make it just the same, okay? Heavy, heavy, heavy. As you get faster, get lighter. No, no. Lighter, not so heavy with your fingers.
Okay.
Yeah.